Hey, welcome to Zach's Tech Turf and weekly download episode number 92. Thank you guys so much again for all of the feedback you left on Monday's video. You guys gave me so much valuable information on how I can improve my channel. On today's episode, I'm going to be playing some Doom when I give you this news. I got my cup of coffee right there. Make sure you guys let me know in the comment section what you're sipping on. Let's get into it. To start off the tech news this week, there's some pretty solid rumors floating around that there are indeed new AMD Threadripper CPUs coming with the Zen Plus architecture. Apparently, there was a document accidentally uploaded to the AMD website that listed SKUs for a Threadripper 2950X, 2920X, and a 2900X. We don't have any more information like clock speeds or core counts, but it's definitely some good news to see them updating this processor line as well. Next up, there was a class action lawsuit filed against the top three DDR memory manufacturers this week for allegedly artificially limiting the supply in order to increase the worldwide price. We all know that DDR4 memory is about double the price as it was about 2 years ago, and it seems, at least in my opinion, that there's a good chance it's because of Samsung, Micron, and Hynix colluded this. These three companies own 96% of the DDR4 memory industry, so it definitely doesn't surprise me. Intel announced this week that they are discontinuing their Kaby Lake X processor family. Kaby Lake X released less than a year ago, and it was sort of like a budget option for the X299 platform. There were definitely some limiting factors such as 16 PCIe lanes and only dual channel memory support, and the 6-core Coffee Lake processors basically hit the nail in the coffin. If you logged on to Twitter this week, then you've probably seen that they want all 330 million of their users to change their passwords to an apparent computer glitch. They said that there's no evidence of misuse or stolen data, but to be very careful, they want everyone to change their passwords. I will get on that. In more security news, 7-Zip has been found this week to contain a pretty critical security flaw. The Center for Internet Security discovered a security vulnerability that can enable arbitrary code execution in all versions before the most recent one, 18.05. This was just updated a few days ago, so if you haven't updated 7-Zip in a while, you should probably do so. The new Oculus Co standalone VR headset popped up on Amazon this week and actually sold out within a couple of hours. The Oculus Co is a $200 VR headset that doesn't use your phone, computer, or anything like that. The hardware is all inside, and it's also rocking an LCD panel with a resolution of 2560 by 1440p, and it seems pretty legit. And to start off the PC gaming news for the week, one of my top 5 nostalgic games of all time just released on PC again, Star Wars Episode 1 Racer. It's now available on GOG for less than 10 bucks, and oh man, I really miss this game. I probably wouldn't have nearly as much fun now, but I put a ton of hours into it when I was a kid. Next up, Steam just added official support for the Nintendo Switch Pro controller this week. Just like with the Steam, Xbox, and PS4 controller, you'll now have full access to tweaking the controls exactly how you want them, and it's nice to see Steam continually adding support like this. Right now it's only available in beta, but we should see it added to the full version of Steam here soon. And to wrap up the PC gaming news, you can now pick up a free copy of the first Witcher game by simply signing up for the GOG newsletter. I'll have it linked in the description. I personally haven't played the first Witcher, but I've heard that it has a lot of important story info that you've probably seen from The Witcher 3, and hey, it's free 99. Well, that wraps up weekly download episode number 92. Don't forget that the weekly download podcast is also available on platforms like Google Play, iHeartRadio, and even an Amazon Alexa skill. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please drop a like down below to help support my channel. And as always, thank you for watching. And please subscribe for more Zach's Tech Turf videos.